in this video I'll review my point of view demo from a recent EVL Highlander Battle Royale tournament on CP Process. I'll talk over the decisions I make and why to help you get a better understanding of how to play Highlander Heavy. This is a map that was played in the finals of the EVL tourney, where my team played another team made up of primarily K&D players. Alright, and I decided to sort of break from doing maps from the past UGC season because this map was played recently on Process, and then Process is map of the week this week in UGC. So, here we go. This is rolling out GRU, obviously. I'm gonna get to mid as fast as possible. You wanna make sure you know the timings and you take off your GRU soon enough so you're not taking mini crits when you get into mid, because it's something that can happen if you're just not paying attention when mid or you're sort of new to running GRU. Here I'm just trying to be revved up and spamming in case they get aggressive over a point, but we lose our sniper and our scout early, so we're just trying to leave as soon as possible. And here, since our soldier's bombing and they were pushing sort of initially, I just immediately went to sort of fight them, try to slow them down so they might get out, but they didn't end up committing there. Since it's even, I sort of went up top there to be in a place where I wouldn't take damage, and so my med could just give heals sort of scout and demo, and sort of allow them to push if needed or deal with anybody sort of fighting and choke. Because just a heavy sitting there, I would just take too much damage from spam. Here we end up trading ubers. Trade goes fine. Doesn't really favor anyone particularly. We are two down, so we're sort of expecting them to push. And since our soldier's dead, I'm trying to pay attention a lot to IT, because that's usually where you'll see a soldier play. I'm just trying to look around, be vigilant, make sure we're not getting flanked. Just missed bumping into the spy there, sadly. Since we have the demo pick, we're going to try to sort of pressure through choke, and so I'm going to be close. Because usually if you come through choke, you can expect a soldier to bomb into you as you're all clumped up. And then at least my presence there will help us just sort of force our way in with my large health pool, and to sort of protect our med as we walk in so we don't get forced. Here, since I'm low, I'm not really going to be able to chase down anyone. I'm just going to eat my sandwich and be ready to come back in. Here, since we killed their med, we just need to all out protect our med, because we expect them to be suiciding. But yeah, here we go, no pause. I think this only lasts maybe 30 seconds, but I will try to fast forward through it. So yeah, since their med's down, we just all out need to protect our med. Especially on a map like this, because we have picks, we'll be able to roll in through second. And taking second, that will give us time to build Uber, and so we'll have a full Uber ready to push last. So hopefully I don't go too far. I don't remember this pause being all too long. Then again, I guess I can just go full speed, because if I miss a few seconds, it won't really matter. I guess the pause is a lot longer than I expected. Sorry for this. So essentially when it gets on pause, I'm going to be trying to go straight to our med, because I know that their sniper, their soldier are all alive, and their demo. So I'm expecting a lot of people to be bombing. So yeah, I just tried to run straight to the med there. Then I start moving forward, because we have a big player advantage. Their sniper is alive, and so we're a little bit wary of that, and so we just are going to be pushing through IT to avoid the sniper sightlines as much as possible. Unfortunately, the HUD's going to be broken for a little bit. And since they got spawns, we're just going to be waiting to push until we get Uber. So So we're working through, I'm just trying to be close enough to support them getting through IT, but not actually really come into the Uber. I know there's a spy behind, so I'm just trying to be aware of that. When you're taking second, a good spot for you to go as heavy is just right on the point. There I drop off looking for ammo, but yeah. Playing on the point allows you to really deny them from pushing in from anywhere, whether it be lobby, rollout, or shutter. Allow you to protect your med from bombers and just deny their aggression. That's a pretty good spot if you know they're pushing and you have player disadvantage. Because you can really just shut them down. Here, since we're going to be fairly close to Uber ourselves, we're just going to be playing passive and trying to shut down their push. And then be in a position to repush. And so here I'm just trying to stay on the high ground and deny them from pushing in. Here we know there's a few players behind us, but we have advantage, so we're getting ready to push. Just trying to avoid the sniper. Here I'm probably going to dot a spy. Since I was so far away from the combo when they were trying to Uber in, I just made sure to stay out of it. And I tried to just go to rollout, because oftentimes teams, more specifically their flank classes, will push sort of away from where their combo's Ubering in. And so if you're there ripped up, sometimes you can get a free kill or two. Here, since we're getting spawns, we're going to be peeking and fighting them. Their demo's aggressive on the ground alone, and he's not being healed, and so we're going to be trying to pressure them immediately. Here, I just sort of walk over to the left and probably going to eat a sandwich. I accidentally dodged the arrow there. Yeah, I just tried to walk forward, make space for my team there, and then with the goal of allowing my med and demo to walk in, but didn't really work out because they kept pressuring, but we ended up getting the force, which was ultimately better. Here it seems like the sniper's lobby based on that dot, so we're just going to be trying to come and roll out. Again, I'm trying to stay out of it initially because I know that I won't really be able to accomplish anything from directly being in the Uber from rollout, because it'll be just so far away from me that there'll be nothing for me. There I try to come in post-Uber, but our Uber sort of gets pushed out of last, and then there's no real positioning over on the left, no space for me to really play in, so I end up going down. Here, just respawning. Since our combo lived, we're going to be trying to hold second again. Our med's pretty far out there, so I'm going to be trying to make sure I get in, try to make space so that our med can either get out or stay in to fight. Here we get a pick on their meds, so especially since we're about to push last, you gotta be extra defensive. I see their demo and their scout running away, and I believe their soldier's dead. Oh, yes. Looks like the HUD's working, their soldier was lobby. So I'm just peeking roll out, getting what info I can. And here, since we have advantage, just gonna walk in. Here's a play that I like to do. It's pretty much just Ubering the demo and the heavy straight to the point, because once I get to the point, I'm gonna have 450 health on the point, and they can either come down to kill me, or if what they're doing, like most teams, they'll just sort of be back up top or right by their spawn, sort of kiting the Uber. And so oftentimes you can get a lot of cap time before they're actually able to come forward and kill you. So that's something that works out pretty well, assuming you don't get sniped like I did there. But ultimately, we do win the round. This mid, we're going to be trying to go left. And so essentially, we're just going to come up left, get heals to our demo, and then have our soldier bomb to distract them. And then everyone is pretty much just going to flood over the left side here. I just wanted to make sure I did as much damage to their demo, hopefully kill them, or at least force them to leave there, because surviving as a heavy is not that big of a deal, but if I could have traded for the demo there, that would have been much better. So that's just what I was going for. Here, I know the spy's behind, so I'm just making sure I don't get surprised. There, Muma, our soldier, is trying to get a fast bomb in to force them or get a pick, and that doesn't really work out. I think I had called to go into IT to try to get some sniper cell line set up, but instead we're just going to be fighting them choke. Here we end up using, and I believe they popped as well. I'm just making sure there's nothing sort of juking around the rock, and then I come forward to help the combo. Since we killed their med, we're just going to be trying to play slow and together and play heals as much as we can. End up catching the spy there. Here, since our demo's forward, I just tried to rush in to make sure I was close enough to help him. Sadly, I had just thrown my sandwich there. And sword med's quite low. Again, just playing on the point, getting cap time, and just being in a position to shut down any people pushing. I don't remember exactly what we do, but we might actually go in bottom left here. Going bottom left can be a pretty good option with advantage, because oftentimes if their sniper's dead or not looking at you, you can sort of walk in for free, at least partway. And then in the post-super fight, you have that wall on the left side of point that you can sort of play behind. So that's an option. Works fairly well, depending on the team you're on. But it does require you bringing in like fast classes into the physical Uber itself. Here we get to pick on their demos, so we're just going to be pushing right away, likely. There, I peeked the corner without being revved. That was a bit of a mistake on my part, but I doubt the scout would have died either way. Here we end up going in left. I'm just trying to stay out of it and be rollout so I can sort of shoot people in the side if they try to overcommit and fight our combo. But they don't, so we just end up trading Ubers and sort of reset the situation. But we end up losing two players, so they might be trying to push out, especially since we lose our sniper. This is a spot I really like, because only your head peeks out and you can just shoot and destroy anything that's rollout. I like this spot when you know they're pushing, because oftentimes, worst case scenario, you'll kill the first thing that comes around the corner, or you'll force their Uber, so it's a pretty good spot to just sort of suicide and stay in. Because it's a pretty high percentage play, especially with Tomislav, because they won't hear you revved. Oftentimes teams will push out of rollout when they have an advantage, and so this spot can really catch them unaware. Since they have advantage, I'm just sticking forward, because I'm expecting them to push. But since their advantage is so small now, likely they won't be pushing. But in general, I just feel like playing there and forcing their Uber with my life is definitely worth dying. Here, we're just trying to rotate around, see if there's any picks that we can get. Again, since we're just sort of waiting for our sniper to respawn, I'm just playing close to rollout, so in case anything peaks, we'll be able to get an easy kill on them. Here, since this is a dispenser, there's no reason not to just be continuously shooting. You can spy check and just have your damage ramped up in case anything peaks you. I think this is something that, even myself, I don't do it enough, but whenever you have a dispenser, like, it's perfectly fine to just be shooting continuously, because the damage ramp up is a pretty significant factor. There, I think I try to peek forward with our sniper to give him some protection, but we end up both dying. Actually, it looks like he died before me. Don't know if it's because he was on a different spawn wave or if he just died way before me and I didn't notice. But here, they end up coming out. Our Uber's going to last longer, so hopefully we can get kills. Doesn't look like it, though. We lose three, so we're probably going to be backing out. Although our sniper gets two important kills, especially on that demo right there, so we'll be able to hold. Since their demo's dead, I'm going to be trying to peek a little bit, see if there's any openings. But yeah, back to my point about just shooting continuously, it'll frustrate spies as long as you're being smart with what you're spy checking. And then you're just set up to deal with anything that pushes you, because your damage is ramped up. It's not really stated anywhere by Valve, but you have to be shooting for 1 second for your damage to reach its maximum, and then being revved up for 1 second will increase your accuracy to maximum. Might be 2 seconds, I'm not 100% sure, but just in general, just remember to always be pre-firing around corners if you're peeking, or if you know there's a fight about to happen, or if you're in a fight, just never let go of mass one. So just trying to make sure you have ammo before you go into a fight, that's pretty important. Here I just sort of peek roll out as we pressure from the... Well, since I knew they were fighting us on left, I just tried to peek roll out and shoot them in the side. Sadly, their heavy lives with like one health. Here we force their uber, and I'm just committing to roll out to make sure they can't get in that way, and I pick up their heavy and their sniper, trying to get out. And so I just try to pressure forward and roll out to hopefully cut off their escape if they come out lobby. Here their med is close. I'm just doing whatever damage I can. I expected our team to be pushing more there since we had a decent amount of picks, but I guess they were pushed back after the uber. But we get in now, and I believe we'll get the last gap, maybe. Maybe not, actually. Since we have our demo down, they're likely going to be pushing, so we're just going to try to keep our sniper up. He's pretty low health, but looks like he'll live. They're all leaving through IT, so I'm just trying to be passive and sort of slow them down if I can until they sort of get back into position to fight. Corsa manages to kill their demo, which is really big, so we'll be able to hold this most certainly. Now just sort of playing choke, trying to delay their overall push in. Here the super gets forced out from both teams, but we're down so many that we'll likely die in this post-super, but actually our med gets out and so does our demo. So we lose second. It's been kind of boring, to be honest. We've just been sort of sitting at their last, but we managed to get out with our med alive on a mid. Here we were just sort of waiting for our spawners to come, so we were just backing up and being passive. There are soldier bombs and gets their meds, so we're just going to be slowly retaking as a team and just making sure that we're playing close enough together that a suicide doesn't come in and take our med. There, I just try to get aggressive forward since their med was, or their demo rather, was still committed on right. I just wanted to cut off his retreat. Then I'm just making sure sewer was clear there. And now I'm just going to be rotating through choke with our combo. In these times when you're pushing, especially while pushing is the time when soldiers tend to come in, because oftentimes the heavy won't be revved, so just trying to be extra vigilant of where players are and what's coming into you is very important. We end up killing their med again, and so we're just going to be slow and defensive as we make our way in. Since we have a lot of picks, we're likely just going to swarm in as soon as we can. Their sniper's watching roll out, so I'm going to just run the other direction. Here we're just doing a good job of continually getting kills, so I'm just going to be trying to pressure in, sort of distract their spawners, and do whatever damage I can. Here I just try to run and eat a sandwich, get up to full health in case the rest of our push somehow fails, so I can just sort of peek back on the point. But we win our second round, I believe we're up 2-0 now, yep. There's about 10 minutes left in the game. Since our left rollout worked so well last round, I think we're going to try it again. Yeah, our demo's left, so we'll likely be going there. So pretty much, we just all clump up left, and then as soon as our soldier bombs, we just all swarm into them together. There, our demo gets sniped instantly, but because of our aggression, we're able to just overwhelm them completely. Fortunately, our med goes down there, but since we got so many kills, we'll be able to take mid in second. Since they're only two up, I'm just making sure I'm running forward as fast as I can. I want to make sure I'm in position to get cap time and deny them from pushing in a second. Since I know they're going to have Uber, they're going to be trying to push out immediately. So I'm just trying to get there as soon as I can to try to deny them, make them hopefully use for it, or at least get the cap. And here, I just make sure I commit to getting the capture. I managed to get out with my life somehow. I was pretty much just luck. But we get the cap, and so we're able to get forward spawns, which is pretty huge. Even if we just lose it again instantly, we'll be spawning it forwards. So it's sort of a victory in itself there. So we're just set up on mid. We have Uber advantage, since we managed to force them on second there. We're just going to be hanging out until we get Uber. One thing that you can try as a team is sort of rotating your sniper into sewer and sort of playing around your sniper and having them peek out from the sewer shutters. That can be pretty effective for getting picks, especially if it's even. We're a little bit scared to push in because we know the sniper is just going to be staring at us, so we're going to have Mooma bomb in through first to try to get on their sniper or just make space, and we decide to Uber him and Xalox through, and I try to follow up with a combo as soon as I can, try to get in behind them. Fortunately, their soldier comes in from behind, but our med lives. Here we're both down players. I know I'm not going to be able to get out because they're Ubered right there, so I'm just going to try to commit and get what kills I can. I end up killing their NG. Maybe I kill their sniper? No. Not quite. Akuma gets a stab on the red. That was a huge play there. And then since we have our sniper and most of our classes alive, we're just going to be silly working our way to get kills. We have advantage, so there's not like a huge rush to be pushing off the player advantage there, because we just want to make sure we're preserving our med's Uber advantage. Here we get their demo, so we're going to be pushing most likely right away. Then your sniper is just continuing to get kills. Here, spy, just sadly the cloaks are in front of me, but we're getting second, we have a huge advantage, so we're going to be trying to push in pretty quickly. We'll probably wait for our spawns, actually, because having a scout and a soldier would be very important for pushing last. Here again, I'm just trying to peek a little bit, get some info before we push. Just see what to expect. Unfortunately, I take a lot of damage. That was kind of bad on my part to take so much damage. But at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter, since we're going to be Ubering the demo and the scout in either way. And again, like pushing in the second, pushing in the last, I just try to come in a few moments after the Uber, because I know that our Uber will have pushed them back, and then I can sort of come behind, pick up stragglers from their team, and sort of snipe down people who are low health. But the push doesn't really work out. However, we do get our med out alive, and so we'll be able to re-push with our spawns. Or worst case, just hold on to second. Here I'm just trying to get in because we're going to be committing to block second. Again, I sort of walk off to this side here. This is a pretty good spot because you can shoot bombers and fight them from the edge of that ramp, which only your head pokes out, so you can do good damage without taking it. But unfortunately, their scout chases and kills me. But we end up killing pretty much all their key classes, their demo med and sniper. So we'll be able to push in right away here with our Uber. Here we're just Ubering aggressively, if I remember correctly. I'm just sort of blocking out their spawns with their demo. I think other people should have gotten on point here sooner, but we end up getting a bunch of kills, and so we'll be getting the cap. So we're up 3-0. Since there's only one half in this tournament format, we know we're going to win at this point, but I suggest to just sort of stalemate it out, just seal the win. But since there's only 7 minutes of the map time left, and I believe it's to 4 is the max wins, we'll just be playing sort of normally, but a little bit more defensive. Since they're going right, we decided to go on right and meet them, because going left into nobody sort of defeats the purpose of the push, because the main goal of it is just get that aggression and early damage and sort of overwhelm them. So if they go right, or to your right, you should usually meet them. Here we just sort of play passive, and they sort of come in at different times, and we end up cleaning up a bunch of kills and work our way into second really quickly. Their meta's still in here. Sniper shutter, so I try to hide my head behind that little ramp there, but end up getting stabbed. Since we had so many picks, I sort of expected them to be passive, or holding last, rather, and not actually committing to second, so I guess if we had pushed that a little slower and we had gotten the comms of where they were, I probably would have delayed more when I came in, because right there I was sort of caught in the middle of two Uppers, which wasn't really helping. But I assume they were passive, so I was trying to rush in and deck as much ground as I could. Here it's fairly even. I think our med wasn't healing, so they have a slight advantage. Sort of just being passive. We know they have to push if they want a chance to win. Can't remember if this is the first map or the second map of the best of three, and we won the first map. And so they really have to be pushing, but it might actually be the first one. But again, I just try to toss out the sandwich, help the flank. Something that's sort of an underrated thing to do, I guess I should have been doing it earlier, is just coming out of sewer over to this spot, sort of fighting them from a different angle. Definitely would take less damage than running across through choke. But here, since we're down four, we're just going to be leaving. Kill their snipers, so it's going to be hard for them to push us at all. Looks like their med and their demo are pretty far forward, but falling back, so it doesn't look like they're pushing. But considering that they have to be pushing, essentially, due to the time, our med's just very passive here, very defensive, making sure we don't get sniped, stabbed, or bombed, really. Since we got spawners and we have Uber now, we're sort of working our way forward again, so they can't get in. Since there's only 4 minutes left, we're just making sure we're extra defensive. We don't want to give up silly rounds. Barring like a freak chain stab from their spy, we'll be able to just keep holding mid. Here they Uber in out of necessity. Actually, I think Muma forced them, so that was a huge play by him. Here I barely managed to kill the scout. That's a big thing with Tomislav. If you're playing a team with a very good scout that you know of, I'd recommend shying away from the Tomislav. I guess that sort of depends on if the scout aggressively pressures your combo or not, but it's definitely very hard to kill scouts at close range with a Tomislav. So that's just something to be aware of. If you're playing a scout that likes to just sort of plus forward the combo, then using the stock would likely be better. So here, they lose players, and so we just come in a second, take it. Playing on the point, making sure they can't bomb in and retake ground. Again, since they weren't immediately contesting, and I know they're going to be pushing, I just sort of go into this spot again. Since they have Uber advantage and a sniper pick, they're almost certainly going to push. Soldier end up going down, fortunately, but now that they're right to Uber, they'll probably be trying to pop out. Here they go out through Shutter. So I'm just going to be fighting whatever is coming towards me. Here their demo doesn't take the Uber for some reason, and so he sort of gets stuck in. Their heavy somehow gets into RRT, because they're just going crazy aggro out of desperation, but I'm just sort of holding steady on the dispenser, ammo and health. we lose players, and so they're likely going to be pushing right away. Their demo's close, but thankfully the sniper saves me by killing him. I'm not sure if we win another round or not. It might just stalemate out and then count as us winning a round. Here, since the heavy started to peek, I came up and met him. He managed to run away. So I'm just sort of playing the same position. I know they're like popping out, and so I try to rotate a shutter, but the demo has it trapped. It does quite a bit of damage to me. Again, I'm just chilling in this spot, trying to juke around and deny them from pushing. Here, we're creating a direct hit soldier, just for the fun of it. Then I'm just going to eat a sandwich. There's 30 seconds left. We lose our med, but we're getting kills, and they're only one up. So it looks like we do end up winning another round. So that was just a sort of a long, slow 4-0. Definitely not a roll, but hopefully this video helped. We weren't really holding our own second very much, but hopefully you guys have some ideas for what to do when pushing. I know that usually teams have the most problems pushing last. So hopefully this video helps. Best of luck on Monday.